What is going on, guys? It's been quite some time, probably been about 5 years since I've been pretty active. I've uploaded like a couple videos in the last years, but nothing too consistent, you know? I just wanna let you guys know I'm back. I moved 2 times in like the last year, so every time I got my gaming set up, got ready and all that, I would have to get ready to move again. Now we got our own place, I've got work figured out, and I think I got a pretty decent schedule, so everything will be consistent from now on. In today's video, we got a little bit of me talking about exercising and just not trying to put too much on your mind. Got a little bit of training in there, a little bit of like cooking, and then I take you guys on a weight cut with me in the gym. That's what's in today's episode, guys. You guys could just drop a like if you want to see more of this stuff. Comment down below what you guys think. Let me know what you guys have been up to in the last 4, 5, 6 years. You guys have finished school, if you're in college right now, if you have your own house, if you're in an apartment, if you got your own family. But yeah, guys, just enjoy. Peace.
Just finish the run. I would say not time yourself until your body and like your mind is feeling a little bit more comfortable with doing this. Cause if your brain is just constantly thinking, oh, the time, like then what are you really working on, you know? It's more so you're just trying to push yourself up here to get better. For probably your first like 3 weeks of running, until you actually start feeling healthy and good about it, I wouldn't worry or bother about timing anything. You're trying to get out there, get your body moving, open up them lungs.
And kind of the reason why I'm saying to not time yourself is because everything is up here. And if you're just going too hard, like mentally trying to just constantly push yourself, you're not gonna really see the enjoyment. Like you're just gonna be not stressing essentially, but not enjoying it. Everything's gonna take time. It's not just gonna be here, 1 week later there. Everything's a day by day. And if you do it day by day, it will slowly come to you. But the most important part is always trying to enjoy yourself. as I'm fucking dying and can't breathe full of shitty ass snot. It feels good, right? You know, maybe not during the run. Maybe there's some parts that are good and not everything's gonna be easy, but you gotta kind of know that with life. Like if you want something to change, you gotta start doing the uncomfortable hard shit, or else not liking life or just not doing the things that you really want to do, you'll just be comfortable with everything that you've always had. You've never had like any change, any type of push. And that's really hard for some type of people to just change their entire environment. If it's something you really, really want to do up here in your mind, then your body's gonna eventually follow you and what your mind wants to do. Before you do anything, drink some fucking water. Pause the video. And keep yourself hydrated. I don't know why I can't breathe whenever I finish running. It's like for the next couple hours, my throat's just a little like scratchy. I'm not sure if it's like the bad air, but it's just something that's always happened to me. But I'm just gonna show you a simple breakfast that like I already have ready, pretty much already made. Are you gonna need some huevos, bacon, peppers, onions, and then I already have some rice made. And it's like kind of late, it's 11:30, so like if it's the morning, I pretty much just eat a yogurt, eggs, or like oatmeal or something like that. Sometimes cereal. Cereal I like snack on all the time, but I'm just gonna show you something pretty easy. And guys, I literally never cooked growing up. Like I just ate Hot Pockets, cereal, just anything that was fast, PB&J. So cooking, it just takes a little bit of time, but it tastes better. And the main thing is you can just keep moving. Like it doesn't really slow you down on anything you're trying to do. So I promise it's not hard to cook. And you're supposed to use ham, but I'm gonna be using turkey. So look guys, I literally only got like, I only cooked 2 pieces of bacon. I got 1 piece whole, 1 piece in here. Only threw in 1 egg in here and it's already cooking. Like it's already a whole meal and I have like 1 piece of turkey, 2 peppers, and obviously the rice, you know. But like once it all starts coming together, when you start throwing a bunch of ingredients, everything just kind of builds up and then you're like, oh damn, this is actually a lot of food.
Boys, I think we fucked up. I don't think we have soy sauce, boys.
All right, boys, I am going to run to the store. I will be right back. My mother's speeding by, I'm holding
on. Asking God to help him, are you hitting me? Got the soy sauce, and me personally, I don't like to like actually have a lot of soy sauce flavor. It's just kind of like to bring it together, so like that's it. But some people, they really, really like soy sauce, so they'll use like a lot of dashes of that. But me, I think it's like salty or too, it's too strong. It's a good flavor if you just use a little bit for me.
There we have it, boys, that's it. Nothing too complex, right? Yeah. I said I feel invincible. It's 100 niggas in the spot. I won't keep doing it. It's 85 just to walk through. I don't take to these niggas, cause a lot of these niggas be corny. I'm feeling horny, and I shoot like Robin Hood. I'm up this place.
percolated shit. I got a percolated bitch. I give it a percolated dick. I show it as percolated tricks. Pasco, they know who in the city. Pasco, nigga, you can ask them. Pasco, it's up a city of TD. Pasco, going 50 for 50. I pop the pick up a toilet, then shoot up the party and change the artillery. Energy. I'm giving nothing but energy. I give a perky and Hennessy. I give two shots to the enemy. Hope you remember me. What the fuck a nigga telling me? I spent 250 on my wrist. I spent 250 on my bitch. Diligent niggas doing the dick. Walking in spot until everybody's grip. DJ, crew. My nigga fuck with the rules. Text man, get it, play it back. While the rules throw the bag. You know I'm shooting for the stars. Aiming for the moon. I shoot at any op. Cause niggas know I rule. Send that nigga to the medic. Everything brought no edit.
Oh, fucking
Pablo Store.
Pablo, yeah. And Chapo. Dude, this is fresh. Here, let me get it on my phone. Yeah, dude. Oh, my. This is sick. What is that? Day four. Training of the week done. Like I said, guys, just pace yourself. So, like, the first 3 days, I just did some runs. Simple runs. But then, today, I decided I'm finally going to the gym, which I ran with the backpack on. And the front desk clerk is just like, that's bad for your back. Doesn't that hurt? Yeah, if you want to just find an excuse to not do it, right? But yeah, guys, you just got to keep pushing. Don't go too hard when you're starting out. You just got to slowly pace yourself, and then slowly you'll be able to just pick it up more. Like, just the more output you're able to do. Just start out slow. Just try to have fun with it. That's all. That's what's most important. So I'm going to keep doing this run. I think it's like a total of like 3 miles one way, or yeah, 3 miles one way, 3 miles back. So it's around like 5 miles total, maybe six. And then I'll probably do mitts with my coach pretty soon. And then I'll get some more sparring filmed and all that. I'm not planning to do a fight quite yet. I just gotta get everything situated in my house, make sure everything's good. But yeah, my best friend that I've been training with for like the last 5 years, his name's Julian Ruiz, and he's making his pro debut finally at the Maverick Center, which is in Utah, and it's like the big event center. So it's like I've always been watching him like fight in front of crowds. I've been his corner. I've been like front row for all of like his boxing fights and all that. So now he's actually gonna be fighting in front of an audience for money. I don't have the night off, so I can't go to it, unfortunately. I should be able to watch like a live stream that they have for it. Just all depends with if I'm able to do that with work going on, you know. So the squad is making some move, making pro debuts. The YouTube is back. Bobby Shmurda is back. This is the return, boys. This is it. It's time. I know you guys are still waiting to see me like come back with like an actual setup, right? But yeah, this is just what's going on for now. Nothing's really hooked up. I mean, I got power to everything, but there's no point in like giving a true setup tour if everything's not even connected. Y'all feel me? Great news. Finally, we got my internet. It is finally here. I still gotta get Sony Vegas, which I've been thinking, I don't know, I was gonna maybe think Premiere, but probably just gonna go with Vegas since I already know how to use it. I think Premiere looks a lot cleaner, but I don't know anything about Premiere. So I might as well just like stick with what I know since it's gonna be a lot easier for me to do that. Boys, we got El Introneto. Going on now. Gary the cable guy. Just kidding. Fucking finally got us hooked up, so it's fucking time. And today we actually kind of got something kind of special. Taking y'all to do some weight cut with me. I mean, I ain't fighting, but like I said, my buddy that's making his pro debut at like our big fighting arena in Utah, he's gotta lose weight because you gotta weigh a certain amount on the scale. If you guys didn't know, you gotta go to like the sauna. So all this before you're already like in healthy shape, you're eating like a perfect diet, you're not eating any bad food, nothing at all. And then you have a lot of water before, but then like the last 4 days you start cutting out all the water, and I mean like sweating like major, like in a sauna. So it's super uncomfortable. And you know when you go in a sauna, like once you finish, you're like, ah, water. Well, we're not really allowed to have water, so it's pretty much just human torture is all I can think of it as. So right now I gotta go pick up my buddy Julian, and then we're gonna head over to the gym and then get going on that. Probably not gonna be a whole lot of talking because it's not a fun process. It's just a process that must be done. Just get all the water out, weigh in on the scale that one day, and then you can drink it all back, eat all your food back, and then you'll be up to a higher weight. It's very unhealthy to do, but it's just part of the job. But yeah, guys, I will be taking you to the sauna with me and get this going. I want to see what I weigh.
Nice to me just letting me do that shit anyways. Let me just get in there.
How does this one work? You just got to stand on it?
Yeah, you just stand on it.
Damn, am I really that little?
Oh, yeah, see, you're 115, that's 15
I'm
pounds.
Fucking already like,
dude. Easy work right there.
15 Jesus pounds. Christ. With the camera?
10 pounds.
And the shorts?
You just really gotta get it to where you're 5 naturally.
Oh, fuck yeah.
150. Yeah, 0.8,
fuck
0.8.
Yeah.
Nice. It's only 4.
Only
just 4,
pounds,
bro.
We can get this shit.
Good work, G.
Out.
We just did our first session.
What is that? 49?
Fuck.
Like I said, we got a little bit more.
Jump on that now.
29.2 or 29.
127.
That's already like 7.
8, 9.
Dude,
you went from 129
to
729, huh?
And then from you at 151. Pretty close. Yeah. We're almost at 47.
One more, I think.
Yeah, one more session. 147.
Yeah.
Yep. That's
pretty
it.
Pretty much main weight.
Just
gotta wait till we fucking win.
Yep.
Dang.
Yeah, 126.
Yeah. 126.
I made weight.
On the money, sonny.
Right?
Fuck yeah.
So yeah, guys. I guess there's some bad news with him fighting. His opponent took a boxing match last weekend, and the dude got TKO'd. So the commission, like the whole medical side, they said his opponent can't fight since his head has been hit, and you have to take like a 30-day suspension or whatever, you know. So, but Julian, you know, he's a motherfucking champ. He got the 145 belt and he got the 150 belt in Utah for amateur fighting. But this was supposed to be his pro debut, you know, making money and all that, right? But he decided, since, you know, you signed the contract and what you're gonna do, he signed the contract saying he's gonna make weight. So we still wanted to cut weight and still make sure everything's good on our end, you know. So I helped him, which I started out at 131. And then we did like a 20 minute, we did, yeah, like 15 or 20 in the steam room. Then we did another 20 in the sauna, and then got out, did like 5 in the hot tub, another 20 in the sauna, and then like a last 15 minute or another 20 minute in the sauna. And then we just started dropping. Julian started out at about 151 today, and before that he was like 158 yesterday because he cut some water as well yesterday. But he said he wanted to do that just because he hasn't cut weight to 45 or 46. He's got to weigh what, 146 for the weight. If it's a championship, then you got to be 145. And he said, oh no, I wanted to make sure I make the weight because his body hasn't been around that weight for a while. It's normally been around like 170, 165, 160 range. Today we got down to like 147.4 or something. So he's just gonna sleep, take a nap, and it should be around 146 like in 4 hours later or so, once it's time to weigh in. If not, he'll just take one hot bath and just get like a half pound off, and then he's good. I started at 131 today, and then I just did all those sauna sessions with him, and then now I'm at 126, which is the fighting weight. But I talked to a professional the other day, and he was saying I can actually make 115. So in my mind, I think like long-term professionally, I would have to fight at 115 or like 118, around that range. I didn't think that I could get that small, but honestly, like I don't feel that dry, just my mouth. I need some fucking water, mate. But like my eyeballs, they're not sucked in too bad. My cheeks are a little bit more than normal. But my energy and everything feels good. It's not like my voice, it's hard to talk. Julian, it's harder for him because he's already been cutting a little bit, you know? So I think that's how I would feel. I'd feel like, you know, if you've seen the picture of Conor McGregor when he's cutting weight, he doesn't even want to stand, you don't want to talk, you don't want to do anything, you don't want to think. It's just because you have no energy and you just feel super, super dry, you know? So
I just want to wrap up the video by saying, guys, I know it doesn't seem like we're that bummed out about not being able to fight, but it's just kind of the mindset you have to have when you're training all the time, putting in all the work, or, you know, trying to be the best version of you. Can't control everything. There's only like so much you can do yourself. But yeah, I was very excited to watch him fight, but that didn't happen. Next video I'm doing definitely is going to be my gaming setup, so you guys will definitely want to check that one out. Yeah, guys, I will see you guys in the next video. Hopefully you enjoyed this one. I will talk to you guys later. Peace.